practice is called self-compassion breaks, and it's something you can do anytime during the day or night when you need a little self-compassion. So to practice this exercise, we actually need to call up a little suffering. So I invite you to think about a situation in your life right now that is difficult for you. Maybe you're feeling stressed, or you're having a relationship problem, or you're worried about something that might happen. I invite you to think of something that is difficult, but not overwhelmingly difficult, especially if you're new to practicing the self-compassion. Finding a situation and getting in touch with it. What's going on? What happened? Or what might happen? Who said what? Really bring the situation to life in your mind's eye. And then I'm going to be saying a series of phrases that are designed to help us remember the three components of self-compassion when we need it most. So the first phrase is, this is a moment of suffering. We're bringing mindful awareness to the fact that suffering is present. And I'd invite you to find some language that speaks to you. Something like, this is really hard right now. Or, I'm really struggling. We're actually trying to record our difficulty, acknowledging it, naming it. This is a moment of suffering. The second phrase is, suffering is a part of life. Okay, we're reminding ourselves of our common humanity. Suffering is a part of life. And again, finding language that speaks to you. It may be something like, it's not abnormal to feel this way. Many people are going through similar situations. And the degree of suffering may be different, the flavor of suffering may be different. But suffering is a part of life. Part of being human. And then the third phrase is, may I be kind to myself in this moment. And to support bringing kindness to yourself, I'd invite you to perhaps put your hands over your heart or some other place on your body.